The following program is brought to you in living color on MBC.
Scotty.
It could be worse, but I can give you more powder if you need it.
Spock, report.
Our last two shots inflicted serious damage to their primary hull. They have changed course and are retreating beyond phaser range.
Don't ever call this ship a big lumbering moose again.
Not moose. Cow.
You've made a big mistake. There will be consequences, I promise.
Space. The final frontier. These are the new voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its five-year mission: to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before. USS Enterprise, Captain's personal log. My nephew, Peter, has been assigned to the Enterprise as an ensign. And this incident with the Klingons, it worries me. What dangers am I exposing him to? I haven't seen Peter in too many years. I don't even know him. How do I make him understand this isn't a game out here?
Over there. Wait over there.
Freeman, get him out of here. We've got real wounded.
I'm fine.
Any day now, Freeman. Okay, now you're done. Hand me a deep scanner. He may have internal bleeding. Yeah, he's Peter Kirk. But you treat him like everyone else, you got that?
Yes, sir.
Fontana, go heal something. Freeman, you moved too long in the same place. Go help her, I've got this.
Captain, it's a distress signal, sir. The Copernicus, a research vessel.
We're in no shape to help.
Who else is in this quadrant?
There are no other Starfleet vessels this far out. We are 10 hours away at warp factor 2.
The Klingon ship?
Is no longer an immediate threat.
Neither are we. Inform command will respond as best we can. Mr. Chekov, lay in a course. Mr. Scott, what speed can you give me?
Cut. We've got a busted wing. A cunner.
Mr. Scott, I need warp factor 4.
I can give you a warp factor 2, and not a wee bit more.
Acknowledged. Mr. Chekov, ahead warp factor 2.
Captain's log supplement. We are still several hours from the Copernicus, and her distress signal continues to repeat. I have asked Mr. Spock to assemble a mission team.
Nope, not him. Take Freeman instead. He's a medical technician.
Captain, is it possible you're being overprotective?
He's not going.
That swaggering, tin-plated, stupid son of a bitch! If he weren't my uncle, I'd...
You seem upset.
He took me off the mission team.
You are taking this personally.
Yes, I am. He made it personal. He's afraid I'll fall off my bike again.
You expect too much from him. He is only human.
He's not human! He's James T. Kirk!
And you want to be just like him. You are his nephew. I'm on duty now. You are in my way.
Right. Have fun.
Fun?
Guess who?
Mr. Sulu.
You wish. I heard. I'm sorry. I know how much you wanted to go.
There'll be other opportunities. Watch the burn.
It still hurts?
Yeah.
Yeah, let me see.
Careful.
That could be worse.
Make everything all right.
Not this time.
What?
They put me on the mission team.
No.
Yes.
Do you think he knows about us?
I don't see how.
He has to. Maybe he thinks I'm here because I wanted to serve under him. He's such... I'm here because of you. And only you. I got it. Will you marry me?
How many times are you gonna ask me? I already said yes.
No. Here. On the Enterprise. I'll ask him to do it. Say yes.
Of course.
You know him better than I do. What do you think he'll say?
I don't know him at all.
We'll do it right after you finish rescuing everyone on the Copernicus.
I wish I was going.
I want you to go. You've got to be brave for both of us now.
Have I told you today how much I love you, Peter Kirk?
I love you too, Alex Freeman Kirk.
Red giant, blue dwarf pair.
It's beautiful, Mr. Spock.
The paired stars are far more interesting as a scientific phenomenon. The red giant is named Lear, after King Lear. The blue dwarf is Iago.
Somebody didn't know their Shakespeare very well. A Russian wouldn't make that mistake.
It is a metaphor, Mr. Chekhov. The red giant is a very old star. The blue-white dwarf is pulling the fire out of it. It will take thousands of centuries, of course.
Still a spectacular view.
Mr. Chekhov, locate the Copernicus.
There they are. That can't be right. Captain, their orbit will take them right into the streamer. They'll burn up.
How long?
18 hours.
What kind of an idiot puts his ship in a self-destruction orbit?
Perhaps we should ask what kind of circumstance requires it.
Life signs, Mr. Spock.
Indeterminate. There's too much interference to get a clear reading.
Lieutenant Uhura.
Still no response, Captain. Nothing.
Keep trying. Mr. Chekhov, take us in. Match your orbit and put us within transporter range.
What the hell is happening on that ship?
Captain's log, Stardate 6429.2. We have matched orbit with the Copernicus, and we're still unable to detect life signs. Mr. Scott has confirmed that we don't have the power to tow her out of danger. Before this day ends, the Copernicus will be a memory. The rescue party will search for survivors and retrieve the log as quickly as possible.
Don't go trying to be a hero. I've already got enough heroes on the ship.
Yes, sir.
We're stretched too thin, Spock. Between our own casualties and the damage to the Enterprise, if the Klingons should attack again.
It is a risk we will have to take, Captain. The Copernicus will burn up in 12 hours.
Captain Kirk!
Peter.
Ensign Kirk, sir.
Ensign Kirk?
Permission to speak? You took me off the mission team. May I ask why?
It was the appropriate decision.
What was appropriate about it, sir?
Peter, this is...
Ensign Kirk.
Ensign Kirk?
Sir, you could tell me it was an appropriate decision, and I'll believe you. But what about the rest of this crew? I'm as well trained as anyone. And if I'm not put on a mission team, will it look to them as if you're trying to protect me? And if the crew starts to believe that, I won't be able to function here. I'll have to ask for a transfer. And so will my husband.
Husband?
Yes, if you'll marry us. Lieutenant Alex Freeman, medical technician.
Marry you?
After this mission, sir.
I see. Will talk about it. After the mission. I mean, setting a date for your wedding.
Thank you, sir.
And I guess congratulations are in order, aren't they, Ensign?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Ensign, would you care to join the mission team?
Yes, sir. Very much, sir.
Go get your gear. Spock, am I the only one who didn't know?
I believe Mr. Scott might have been too busy to notice.
Thanks, Spock.
Seconds to optimal range.
Let's find a safe place to put them down.
I'm picking up hard interference from the cargo bay.
Interesting. It is a series of concentric repulsor fields.
Repulsor fields? At that strength, they'd have to be used in the ships to remain in power. They must be trying to contain something big.
That would be a logical assumption.
You'll have to work fast, Spock. That beacon is a signal. If the Klingons should pick it up.
I'm certain they already have. We must move quickly. Lieutenant Rand, come with me. Rand, Hodel, your first priorities, retrieve the log of the Copernicus, shut down the distress signal. Freeman, DeSalle, look for survivors. Ensign, stay with me.
Mr. Spock, be careful.
Of course, Captain. Energize.
My nephew. On a security team.
Relax, Jim. We don't put bullseyes on the red shirts anymore.
Phenomenon that demonstrates the characteristics of both wave and particle.
You mean it can't make up its mind what it wants to be when it grows up?
Lieutenant, particles do not have minds.
Hey, that tickles.
Mr. Freeman.
Sorry, sir.
The properties of wavicles are in constant flux. That's why your tricorder readings are confused. We would need a magnetonic deconstructor to isolate the transactions.
Mr. Spock. Bridge.
It's been welded shut.
J.
Captain, are you picking this up?
We see it, Spock. We will need to use the manual access.
Lieutenant, ask Starfleet Command for a Code 9 review.
Acknowledged. He sent the distress signal.
Mr. Freeman.
Sir, there's no blood in this man's body. None at all.
Mr. Spock.
That's a phaser blast, Mr. Spock.
Clearly. Check the consoles. Mr. Odell, Lieutenant Rand, the log, the beacon.
Console's been destroyed.
You too, Mr. Spock.
Mr. Spock, it's the whole damn bridge.
I'm getting some kind of movement on the Copernicus. Life signs, I think.
Location.
It's very strange. I can't get a focus. But it looks like it's headed toward the bridge.
Spock, could you copy that?
Acknowledged.
I'm getting something.
I'm reading it too. Getting stronger. Coming from...
You're too late. You're all dead. Everyone's dead. You'll see. You're next. All of you. You're next!
What's your name, crewman?
Aarons. What are you doing?
It'll help with the pain.
Oh, God, no! What have you done? It's happening! Kill me!
Enterprise?
Please kill me!
Mysterious life forms are here and injured crewmen.
No, that's not what I'm reading. Whatever it is, it's still moving towards you.
Damn you!
Safe! No!
Enterprise, acknowledge. Enterprise, acknowledge.
We did.
Captain,
We have to assume this entire ship is contaminated.
Gentlemen, options.
Scotty, what about the transporter's biofilter?
The beam won't allow the particle to form. That'll certainly replicate the wave component. And that'll be enough. They'll slip right through.
Can we beam them to an isolation bay inside a repulsor field?
If it were strong enough, maybe. But one repulsor field won't be enough. You need at least 6 or 7 concentric fields. And even then, I cannot guarantee field integrity. Not in our present condition.
Captain, the mission team will not beam back. We cannot risk infecting the Enterprise. Do you agree?
I do, Spock. The safety of the Enterprise must come first. Spock, I need that ship's log. Find it.
Acknowledge. Spock out.
Jim, we need to talk.
Turbolift. Hold.
Jim.
Bones. We're thinking the same thing.
Plasmacytes. Goddamn bloodworms.
Regulan bloodworms.
The entire Regulan system's been under quarantine for over 100 years. I mean, how in the hell could this happen?
The Copernicus must have violated that quarantine.
Yeah, or the bloodworms broke out.
Bones, you've got to find an answer. I know, you're a doctor, not a miracle worker. Find something. Anything.
There should have been a Jeffries tube around here. I hate it when they do non-standard mods.
There's gotta be an access.
Here. This should work. Let's get it open.
This could get bad. I wish you'd stayed on the Enterprise.
You sound like my uncle.
Don't be insulting. Hey, what did he say?
He said,
husband, marry you. We'll talk about it. After the mission. I mean, setting a date for the wedding. Uncle Captain, what kind of a family am I getting into?
Stubborn. Pig-headed, arrogant.
And incredibly good where it matters.
Yeah. What about your family?
They're boring. I told you, they're... I mean, we're all kind of the same.
Do you think they'll like me?
Yeah. It's just... They're kind of...
Good. I got it. Let's get it open. Yep. This'll do. Kirk to Spock. Ensign Kirk to Commander Spock. We found something, sir.
A Odell immediately.
Acknowledged. Kirk out.
I'll go.
Main energizers are barely holding.
This ship really took a beating from them Klingon bastards.
Yeah, well, so did the crew. Hey, you know some of them haven't slept in three shifts?
Sleep? There's no such thing. It's just an old space tale like Sparkle Dancers or Klingons with a heart of gold.
No, I remember sleep. I did it once. You lie down and don't do anything for 6 hours. Wonderful. What's a Sparkle Dancer?
It's a space butterfly. It's supposed to be good luck. If you pure of heart, they're supposed to dance with your ship.
Well, then I have nothing to worry about. I'm pure of heart. I'm Russian.
If you ever meet someone who's seen a sparkle dancer, find out what he's drinking and order me a case.
Gentlemen,
Lieutenant Uhura.
Captain, backtrack the Copernicus. She came from the regular system.
Thank you, Mr. Chekhov, we know. Pay attention.
Captain Kirk, we have received your report, and our analysis indicates that your estimates are correct in this situation. Upon receipt of this transmission, you will implement a Code 9 procedure. You will perform this duty without delay and without question. There can be no deviations in the requirements of the Code 9 directive. Jim, I wish there was another way. You and your crew have my sincerest regrets. Admiral Koganat.
What's a Code 9 procedure?
Starfleet Command has just ordered us to destroy the Copernicus.
Plasmacytes. They infect the body and transform into bloodworms.
Rescue is impossible.
Dr. McCoy!
Scotty, I'm all out of miracles.
Mr. Chekhov, you'll prepare to move the Enterprise out of the blast radius. Arm phasers and photon torpedoes. Mr. Scott, I'll need all available power to the shields. Once Mr. Spock has transferred the logs from the Copernicus, we'll take final messages from our mission team. And once that is completed, you will all step away from your consoles. I will personally implement the Code 9 destruct myself.
Captain, you don't have to do this. The Copernicus is headed right for the streamer anyway.
Starfleet Command requires a visual confirmation of a Code 9. And once we have that confirmation, I will submit my resignation to Starfleet Command. And you will assume command of the Enterprise.
Captain Kirk, I'd follow you into hell to rescue a snowball, but take your command.
No, sir. I will not do it.
That's a direct order, Mr. Scott.
And if I refuse?
Lieutenant Uhura, you will assume command and place Mr. Scott under arrest.
No, sir. I will not assume command of this ship.
Mr. Chekhov.
Don't even think about it.
I should have you all arrested for insubordination. But I've never been prouder of you. Dismissed. Kirk to Spock.
Spock here.
Spock, I've heard from Starfleet. Admiral Code.
Code 9. Yes. Captain.
It is the only logical course of action.
Spock.
After the log is transferred, I will inform the mission team.
Spock, I want to talk to Peter. And to you.
It is not necessary, Captain.
And it would be a waste of time we do not have.
Spock. You're right. Enterprise out.
I can't see a thing.
Let's see. Yep. Never see it.
There. That one's locked.
Green to green. In worse situations than this.
Really?
Yeah, no, not really. Ah, here we go. Let's see if the network's still running. Okay, it's good news. We're in.
Ensign Kirk to Commander Spock.
Spock here.
We're accessing the data logs now, sir.
Acknowledged.
It's scrambled and wiped. There's nothing there. I'll try another access channel.
Estimate 2 minutes. 3. Kirk out.
So, how'd you two meet?
It was at the Academy. It was very romantic.
The Academy? Romantic?
It was for me. We were study partners. He helped me pass alien biology. I helped him pass tactics and diplomacy.
Uh-huh.
I told him about my uncle. I think that's why he wanted to be on the Enterprise. There's never been anyone else for either of us.
Ah! What the hell is that?
Mr. Hodel, the rest of the mission team is safe.
Spock, it's time to tell them.
Yes, I agree.
You know what those things are, don't you?
Plasmacytes.
Bloodworms.
Spock has destroyed the ship.
With us still aboard.
Oh no. Oh no!
Peter!
They're coming through!
Time on Star Trek Phase 2.
Captain's log started at 64.29.2. Before this day ends, the Copernicus will be a memory.
Captain, our position is not secure.
Shut up, Spock. That's an order.
Targeting phasers.
Hold your fire, Mr. Pike.
What is your status?
We weren't sure if our signal had gotten out.
You have violated the Regulan quarantine. A Code 9 breach.
That doesn't apply here. We found a way to neutralize plasma sites.
You must be joking.
This so-called cure is just too damn dangerous.
You have not solved anything, Kirk. You have made it worse.
Captain Kirk, can you imagine what would happen if the Klingons spread bloodworms throughout Federation space?
Lieutenant Uhura.
Ensign Jameson.
If the Copernicus, with all of their precautions, could become infected, what could happen to us?
Don't you dare give me any Vulcan blood.
Shut up.
Give it to me.
Don't do it, Fontana. Try it, and I'll declare you unfit for duty.
You sanctimonious bastard.
Captain, what are you doing?
Starfleet gave you a direct order. Starfleet doesn't know a thing about this.
Oh, we'll both be in breach.
It won't be the first time.
Where is Alex?
You're gonna have to monitor me by remote.
It would be a suicide mission, Jim.
No, I'm not going to authorize it.
This isn't negotiable, Jim. Those people need a doctor who knows what he's doing. I'm it.
You lie, Kirk. Every race in the galaxy knows the danger of bloodworms. Destroy that ship immediately. If you do not do it, I will. Lock disruptors on target. Prepare to fire.
Kirk, you fool!